Good morning, and welcome to Windy Gap Reservoir, a reservoir soon to be right-sized, and for all the right reasons.
I've been working on this project for 10 years, and I just can't tell you how proud I am to be here today.
Thank you all for being out here today to celebrate this incredible moment and this incredible example of collaboration. I want to thank everybody who's worked for so many years on this project for so long.
We're proud to support the Colorado River Connectivity Channel project. It really is a shining example of a project that aligns with our Colorado Water Plan. This project shaped my thoughts going into the Colorado Water Plan and how we wrote that, what our purpose was, and it's also one that has multiple benefits, both protecting our water users and our environment.
Simply put, the Colorado River Connectivity Channel Project, undoubtedly named by an engineer, is a civil construction project that will relocate the reservoir's existing southern dike northerly. In its wake, a new, but yet old, Colorado River channel will be reconstructed, allowing the Colorado River just below its confluence with the Fraser River to flow on most days of the year unimpeded, permitting bi-directional travel by fish and all the ecology that make high mountain streams important to the environment and to Colorado. We have a growing state. One of the tools necessary to plan for added population is, in fact, storage. Several agreements that ultimately led to the design, partial funding, and construction of this project that will reconnect the Colorado River in Grant County also contemplated the need and approval of Chimney Hollow Reservoir, currently under construction just over the Continental Divide in Larimer County.
Getting to this point required steadfast commitments and dedication from all these partners. So on behalf of Grant County, I would like to thank our project partners and the work of their staff.
You've heard a lot of names of folks that have been engaged, but there's many more. There have been so many people and entities involved in making this happen. And the biggest thank of all is to Northern Water. Northern Water and Toronto Limited were enemies, to put it mildly, for many years. And we have become really close partners in this project. And, you know, I can tell you, Northern has taken leadership of all the design, engineering, construction. And I can tell you, working with them, that they take as much pride of this project as we do. And that's a big deal.
Not only does it signify what we want, but it signifies the strong collaboration that's brought us where we are today as Colorado. Bringing together the East Slope, West Slope water users, local, state, federal governments, agricultural, municipal, environmental interests, Trout Unlimited, Northern Water, Colorado Parks and Wildlife, Grand County, the River District.
Over the next generation of Americans and the generation after that, I hope that they will look at this project as a model of the kind of collaboration that's required for us to be able to turn something over that we're really proud of.
And the secret sauce that prompted us to gather today is our ability to learn from our past, listen to one another's wishes, and contemplate, can we do things differently? And then ultimately have the fortitude to cross the goal line. The Colorado River Connectivity Channel Project will memorialize our willingness and ability to rebalance how we utilize and enjoy such a vital resource in Colorado. Thank you again for taking your time today to be with us in Grant County.